Provisional assessment. In what cases PA takes place means, first and foremost, department never going to come out with the provisional assessment so motto. Understand? You being an assessee, maybe supplier of goods, supplier of services or both, you may ask for provisional assessment in which circumstances the assessee will beg for the want of provisional assessment from the department means he is unable to identify the value as per the section 15 of the CGST read with the valuation rules, or otherwise he is facing difficulty classification of the rate of tax, namely classification of the goods or services, whether falls under 28% category or it falls under 5% category, huge variation. Classification disputes come, whether it is a 12% or 5%, 28% or 5%, confusion. Therefore, if I pay today at 5%, tomorrow department says 28%, huge penalties I have to pay. Basically, to avoid the penalty. Procedural violation. To avoid this, assessee approaching department officer. To whom? To the department of assistant commissioner or deputy commissioner. So, listen here. First and foremost, here, assessing officer who is competent to grant provisional assessment to the assessee means assistant commissioner or deputy commissioner of central tax. If so, I am presenting here. Assessee, or I can also called assessee as a taxable person. Best terminology to call it as a taxable person. Taxable person. Approach the department officer by making application. He made an application to department officer in form GST ASMT. GST ASMT means assessment. ASMT 01. He should make an application in ASMT 01 to whom? To the department officer. Which category officer means? Listen, assistant commissioner level officer or deputy commissioner. Deputy commissioner level officer to whom assessee should approach with ASMT 01. In the case of provisional assessment. Got the clarity, sir? For the want of PA. Then the department officer verify whether you are eligible for provisional assessment or not. Or sometimes they may get doubt. They may want clarification. Why you want to ask what is the problem? Valuation easy, no? In your case, you add this value. Why not you are adding? Why are you getting confusion? Please let me know. Like that, department before granting the PA will ask the assessee to respond in the form as follows. Listen here. Now department officer asking here in the following manner. Let us say, query raised by the department to clarify in the form here, GST ASMT 02. For which you have to respond or not? Responding to the officer in the form the assessing taxable person responding to the officer. GST, ASMT 03. Are you getting my point, sir? Department officer, Assistant Deputy Commissioner, who received a reply from the applicant for the want of PA, verified, oh, perfect. Oh, you want this much of complication is there, which is not mentioned in the ASMT 01. Fine, we are giving now provisional assessment to you. So, order of provisional assessment. Who will issue? Assistant Commissioner or Deputy Commissioner? Now, here, listen. Here, Assistant Commissioner or Deputy Commissioner now issuing order of provisional assessment. So, he will say here, yes. Order of provisional assessment. Granted within 90 days from the date of receipt of GST, ASMT 01, understand. Order has been granted, PA granted, GST, ASMT 04. This order should be named as in the form of GST, ASMT 04. Is called order of PA granted within 90 days from the date of receipt of AS71. That means maximum duration 90 days only to grant order, namely PA. Now, listen, sir. What happened here? If the PA granted by mentioning like this, listen, all of you. Practically, I am presenting here. Practical provisions here. Sir, total estimated liability approximately, let us say, 20 lakhs. Now ask the assessee, to paid under PA upon demand, let us say 5 lakhs, then balance how much? 15 lakhs, they will ask you to execute for the balance amount, for balance, execute bond. This bond execution is in the ASMT 5. Execute bond for balance amount of 15 lakhs. Form GST ASMT 05. Now got the clarity, sir? Got the clarity? When there is order has been passed, PA, estimated liability is 2 lakh. Estimated liability which month? This should be a month, no? Assume. Which month? Let us say current month. November. It is a liability of November 2019. Estimated liability and paid 5 lakhs. When paid 5 lakhs? Paid is due date, namely 20th December 2019 paid. Is clear, brothers? Any difficulty? Balance amount execute the bond. What do you mean by bond? I will tell you here. Listen, practically, many times execute the bond, and when you come across reading, execute the bond with the security, with the surety, or without security or surety, like that. With or without surety or security, I will tell you. Practically, my dear sir, a bond executing by the assessee in favor of President of India. When you deal with the department, central government of India, you should execute a bond in favor of President of India, binding yourself for the amount which you are going to pay. Here, amount due, how much estimate amount? 15 lakhs. Approximate estimation amount. 15 lakhs to pay. I will pay. President of India, when you demand or on behalf of anybody demands, I am here ready to pay the 15 lakh rupees bond amount. If I say myself may not be worthy, somebody should give guarantee for me, correct? This fellow is good person only, he will pay. Assurance is there. That is called as security. In terms of monetary execution, somebody simply says that if this fellow not paid, I will pay, is a surety. But here, bond required with security but not surety. Surety and security difference is, in the case of security, monetary backup is there, assurance. Surety, reputation is the backup. The reputation of a person is a backup. For example, sir, you went to a shop to purchase a particular, let us say, motorbike, and supplier asks you any surety because you are asking on credit basis. Then you approach me, Rafi sir, you please come give the surety. I went over there. That fellow stand up and warm welcome. Sir, I'm a student, sir, he said. Who? The seller of the motorbike dealer. Then I am giving the guarantee. You please give the bike to this fellow. He will make the payment. If not paid, I will pay. Don't worry at all. Such a oral communication without any monetary binding is called surety. Here they are asking security. What do you mean by security? Monetary binding. Meaning what? Bond. Here bond should be executed with security. Bond with security. Inform ASMT 05. Means I should ask my bank manager where I have the bank account. Banker, you need give the guarantee for 15 lakhs of my bond amount. Banker will say, definitely I will give the guarantee to you, sir, provided as per the RBI norms, we should not give any guarantee without any security. Then what you want me to do? You please deposit in your bank account, in our branch, 15 lakhs. 15 lakhs. And give that fixed deposit to us. Says bank manager, I will write on the fixed deposit, lien to bank guarantee. And I will keep the fixed deposit in my drawer. And I will give a separate certification to you as a bank guarantee. Such a bank guarantee is called as security. Now, what amount of security have to get means, the law said, it should not exceed 25% of the bond amount. It should not exceed 25% of the bond amount. Bond amount how much here? 15 lakhs. So, security should be by way of bank guarantee. Bank guarantee how much means 25% of bond amount. Here bank guarantee is nothing but 15 lakhs multiplied by 25%. Tell me how much comes? How much? 3,75,000 is the security bond and the security bank guarantee. Both I have to submit in the form of ASMT 05. After granting to me ASMT 04, namely order of provisional assessment. Now got the clarity, my dear sir? Any difficulty up to this, my dear? All of Ricardo? Is clear? Any difficulty? Questions are going to come from these areas. Typical situation. Practical one it is. I have executed the bonds, bank guarantees on those days when I was working in the industry under excess myself. We have that time. And the same type of approach is going to be considered in the case of execution of bond bank guarantee when the person export the goods without payment of GST under bond. So anyhow, this is clear up to this? Further, my dear sir, come here. Order has been passed. Provisional assessment is granted. It should be finalized or not? What is the time limit to finalize? Listen carefully. Here we have steps. This PA, all of you carefully listen, this PA should be finalized. This PA should be finalized to become final assessment means FA. I will write FA. FA means final assessment. Listen, within a period of 6 months, within a period of 6 months should be finalized from the date of granting ASMT 04. It should be finalized within 6 months. If not finalized, then no problem, it can be further extended. So I will write here extended period to become FA is further 6 months. First initial 6 months, further 6 months extension period. Who can granted means extended period of further 6 months will be granted by the joint commissioner or the additional commissioner of central tax only empowered. Actually, opposed to whom earlier? Assistant commissioner, deputy commissioner only you dealt with. If it is not finalized, then further extension period is allowed for 6 months. Who will grant this? By joint or additional commissioner of central tax. Sir, that 6 months further also be difficult, sir. What, 1 year over, sir? So complication, sir. Okay, in that case, further also can be extended. Extended further period not exceeding 4 years. Who will extend this particular period means only by commissioner. By commissioner of central tax, for example, I'm telling you. It may be state tax also. Commissioner only can extend for the 4 years time period. totally maximum period of 5 years from the date of AS-74, it should be finalized. Is clearer? Now, this 6 months time period, this 6 months extension time period, 4 years extension period, keep separately. If need arises only, it will take place. Otherwise, it should be finalized within 6 months from the date of AS-74. Is it clearer, my dear sir? Now, for finalization, department officer will call for information. For finalization within 6 months, department calling information. Here, department sending the notice now. Mr. Assessee, you apply for the want of PA, we granted. If you finalize, man, submit the records, submit the information, submit the data, call for information to finalization. By whom? Officer of Assistant Commissioner, Deputy Commissioner. Listen carefully. Here, Assistant Commissioner calling information to submit, calling assessee to submit information, which is GST ASMT 06. GST ASMT 06 calling information to finalize the assessment. Got the clarity? And the assessee should supply or not? Should submit. So, assessee is supplying information to that particular officer for finalization. Listen here. For this, he is responding to the officer. The information submitted. I will say here, information submitted. Information submitted for finalization. For finalization of the project assessment. For finalization department got the information and they will proceed further to pass the order. Yes or no? So now they got the information from the assessee to finalize the order. From here they are finalizing. Final assessment order issued now here. So final assessment order issued GST ASMT 07. Final assessment order has been issued within 6 months. By whom? By AC or DC of Central Tax. Is clear, sir? While doing so, what happened here? Listen to me. Now, when it is finalized, with what amount finalized? Listen, that is also important, no? So, finalization with, look here, let us say, here I will say that finalization taken place with 18 lakhs, with 18 lakhs, example, my dear sir, with 18 lakhs, finalization with 18 lakhs. Now, when finalized, assessment order issued, let us say, order issued, assessment order issued, dated For example, I'm telling you, dated, let us say, any date within 6 months from November. Let us say, January, 25th January. 25th January 2020. With finalization 18 lakhs. Is clear, my dear sir? Now what happened? If there's a case, already you paid how much? 5 lakhs only you paid. But has to pay how much? 18 lakhs. Now, you have been short paid or not? Therefore, less tax paid already. 5 lakhs. The balance amount how much? 13 lakhs. This 13 lakhs short paid. If short paid, you have to pay now that with interest. Getting clarity? So, short paid now has to pay now with interest at the rate of 18% per annum. My dear sir, at the rate of 18% per annum. Am I liable to penalty? Absolutely not at all penalty, because to avoid the penalty only approach for the want of PA. But what happened? Delay happened, no? If delay happened, has to pay interest or not? Interest mandatory to pay. As we understood section 75, subsection 9 of the CGST. Therefore, I am paying the interest. Why? Interest from which date? Due date is what? 20th December, but till January 2020 have not paid. Therefore, from 21st December 2019 till the date of payment of this shortfall, I have to pay interest. Repeating, from 21st December 2019 till the date of payment of this shortfall of 13 lakhs, I have to pay interest at the rate of 18%. There may be a possibility that the finalization taking place only with 2 lakhs. If so, I came to know that I paid excess. How much? 3 lakhs. I can ask for refund under section 54. Yes, I can ask for refund. I made application for refund. They should grant refund to me. Dash. Within 60 days from the date of receipt of my application for refund. If they are not granted, they have to pay to me with the interest at the rate of 6% per annum after expiry of 60 days till the rate of payment. That you are aware of that. Is clear, sir? PA granted and finalized in the form of ASMT 07. Is clear? Now, assessee should approach or not? Yes, sir. I paid, sir. You asked me to pay this much, sir, 13 lakhs. I paid, sir. I paid interest, sir. And it should be communicated to the assessing officer. Sir, call for information ASMT 6A. You given the information and department finalized by passing the order. Final assessment passed within 6 months itself with the shortfall of 13 lakhs. You have to pay or not? I paid, sir. Interest paid, sir. Then please release my bond already executed, sir, with a bank guarantee of 25% of the bond amount, sir. I want to get back, sir. You pay the taxes first. This. Have you paid the tax? Paid, sir. Interest paid, sir. Goodbye. Then submit requisition letter. I will release the bond with the bank guarantee. So, assessee now applying to department officer for this order. Assessee reply approaching by submission of dash. Here, finally they submitting here after payment of shortfall GST ASMT 08 for releasing the bond and bank guarantee. AS 70-08 for releasing the bond and bank guarantee, namely security. Further, ACRDC will issue order of releasing of the bond and bank guarantee by way of AS 70-09. After receiving the AS 70-08, then this assigning officer further issue AS 70-09 is called order to release bond and security. Within 7 days of receipt, of AS 70-08. Jury received, submitted, no? Within 7 days, they will grant, they will issue the order, AS 70-09 to release. Is clear, sir? Any difficulty, my dear sir? So, in total, this is a procedure. I have been covered entire thing in one given slide, but it is somewhat narrow to refer, but anyhow. Now, repeating, my dear friends, I am referring dash provisional assessment. Careful reason, provisional assessment, calmly reason. Who will apply for the provisional assessment? Who will apply? Who will apply? Taxable person. Where, when apply means, in the case where difficulty in valuation, difficulty in classifications, then the assessee apply to the ACRDC in the form AS 70-01 for the want of PA. If everything is good, then they will grant order. AS 70-04. No, sir, any difficulty arises while scrutinizing AS 70-01 to grant the provisional assessment, they may ask for clarification. AS 70-02. You have to reply AS 70-03. With all satisfied, finally they are passing the order of AS 70-04, granting PA. This AS 70-12, AS 70-04, the total length of period should not exceed 90 days. Is clear? And AS 70-04, when they granted, they will ask to execute a bond for the differential amount of estimated liability less paid amount. For differential amount, they will ask for bond with the security. So, estimated amount 2 lakhs, amount paid in the month of November 5 lakhs, for the shortfall of 15 lakhs, ask the assessee to execute a bond with security which is not exceeding 25% of the bond amount. Is it clear, sir? Then executed in the form AS 70-05 and given. Now under PA. The PA should be finalized within 6 months period. Within 6 months period. If not finalized, further 6 months can be granted permission for extension by joint commissioner or additional commissioner. If no, then furthermore 4 years can be granted by the commissioner if it is warranted. Is clear, sir? So maximum time period at any cost PA should become FA within 5 years from the date of granting GST ASMT 04. Is clear, brothers? Any difficulty further? If within 6 months wanting to become finalized, AC or DC will call for information. ASMT 06. You supply the information. Verified. Scrutinous. Good. And he is finalizing by passing ASMT 07. Order of final assessment. When passed 25 January 2020. With estimate the finalization of 18 lakhs of tax. But already paid how much? Only 5 lakhs. Shortfall how much? 13 lakhs. For this 13 lakhs, you have to pay what? 13 lakhs of tax as well as interest. From which date the interest should be counted? Means from the due date till the rate of payment. At the rate of 18% per annum. Is it clear, my dear sir? Then, once you paid this, your intimate department I paid in the form ASMT 08. Ah, informed. Sir, I paid, sir. Then, after receiving that, also I mentioned, please release my bond with the security. Then the department officer verify this. Okay, paid all taxes. Fine. Shortfall already paid. 5 lakhs already paid. Shortfall now paid. Interest has been paid. Very good. ASMT 8 submitted. Within ASMT 8 submitted, within 7 days of that application, I will going to release your bond within 7 working days with the security. I will instruct the banker, Mr. Banker, your bank guarantee has been relinquished. Who intimated? Department officer. To whom? To the banker directly. Apart from giving ASMT 09 order of releasing security. With that, the assessee, taxable person, can come to his banker and shows this ASMT 09 bank, the department relinquished the title on this particular bank guarantee, and bank guarantee, please give me my fixed deposit. Then the banker will return back your fixed deposit receipt, where you can go and encash your 3 lakh 75 rupees, what you deposited, you can encash with the interest accrued thereon. Banker, no? Fixed deposit, no? With the interest accrued thereon, you can get back your money. You can get back this. With the interest, you will get back this. By showing ASMT 09. Is clear, sir?